particularly well, but a top five overall finish today. He thinks it's possible too. He hasn't qualified particularly well because it was pretty good. He's confident, he's ready to go.
Well, confidence is good, especially when you're young and fearless. And as you mentioned in the rundown, this is his first ever weekend with a non-go-kart, effectively, when he is running in the series he hopes to be running in full-time to launch his career. When you're 16 and going, hey, I could do this for a living.
Well, yeah, and the thing about this field is...
driver are those three words that you want next to your name, especially when you're 16 and going, hey, I could do this.
The same hope in mind. So it really is a super strong field. I think potentially one of the strongest fields we've ever had, you know, early 20s or less than that, who have exactly the same hope in mind. So it really is a super strong field. I think potentially one of the strongest fields we've ever had in this GT3 Cup Challenge. And, you know, it is a real way to make a name for yourself on the international stage, because these cars race all over the world. If you shine here, you've got an opportunity to go drive a similar car elsewhere in the world as well, and really make a name for yourself and get yourself on the racing ladder. And as you say, hopefully become noticed by Porsche and get onto their junior driver program.
Well, and this was the global debut for Rick, because everybody wanted to be the first one to win.
You're absolutely right. I saw Scott Hargrove just a little while ago as well.
And it was something that really stuck out, because everybody wanted to be the first one to win.
You're absolutely right. I saw Scott Hargrove just a little while ago as well. He said that was a big thing for me, being the first guy to win with this brand new car. And he loves this car. All of these drivers love this new car. It's got more horsepower than last year. You know, they're a lot faster than last year. They're over 3 seconds a lap quicker than last year. I was told by the Porsche engineer on Wednesday that these cars have about 25 horsepower more than last year. Scott Hargrove laughed at me when I talked to him about that yesterday. He said, it's a lot more than that.
That's something that, 25 horsepower.
Horsepower more than last year. Scott Hargrove laughed at me when I talked to him about that yesterday. He said, it's
another thing that we really appreciate this year, new liveries. Lots of shiny colors to keep your eyes on for today's rate comment. The cars have now lined up 2x2. Another thing that we really appreciate this year, new liveries. Lots of around that turn. And a slew of Porsche's 29 cars getting ready to see the green flag. It's waving now, and a bit of a messy start in terms of the back of the field, but the perfect start for Jake Eidson as he goes through completely alone. And Scott Hargrove looking around the outside, trying to keep that second position from Andrew Longe, who makes a dive trying to get up to second place. Ooh, and there's a spin back in the pack. That's Anthony Imparato in the number 91 going around. He had a rough day yesterday. Somebody else went with him in a green Porsche, didn't catch a number on that, but with the gold headlights, that's the number 88. That's Marco Chiaro going around. He had a rough day yesterday. Somebody else went with him in a green Porsche, didn't catch a number on that, but with the gold headlights, that's the number 88. That's Marco Chironi.
Oh, yeah, so it is. That's one of the veteran drivers here in the Gold Cup category. He qualified second place in Gold Cup. Ooh, he got into the back of Imparato. Don't think there's any major damage on either of those cars. They didn't seem to hit anything too solid, I don't think, but a disappointing way to start.
Very. And Marco Chironi, who is the teammate of the young Roman De Angelis, the one that we've been talking up so much, he was second yesterday in the race and was quite surprised at the speed of his teammates. So he was looking for a bit of redemption, not the start he would have wanted to have. And Anthony Imparato, for him, flashes of what happened yesterday. He's not going to be thrilled either. That's going to get into his head a bit for the start of this race, as people are running off the course everywhere.
He's been very unfortunate, hasn't he, Anthony?
Not going to be thrilled either. That's going to get into his head a bit for the start of this race, as people are running off the course everywhere.
He's been very unfortunate, hasn't he, Anthony? Because yesterday he didn't qualify well, had to start back in the pack today. There's
Hargrove's hit a sign.
Yes, he has.
Hargrove has...
Where has he been then?
He's been off-roading
off
on
road
his Yokohamas, and he has half of a sign covering half of the front of his...
That is going to be something. He's going to have to keep his eye on the temperature gauges in that car, no doubt about it. He pulls out to the inside. One thing about these cars, they get a tremendous side draft. I was talking to Price Cobb, massively experienced driver in the paddock. He is a kind of driver coach advisor for the Moore Speed team that run a draft. I was talking to Price Cobb, massively experienced driver in the paddock. He is a kind of driver coach. You get a huge slipstream. And they did a test session with Earl Bamba at Circuit America's. Close to tail in these cars, you don't get much of a draft. But if you're alongside, you get a huge slipstream. And they did a test test session with Earl Bamber at Circuit Americas last year. It was Earl that taught them that trick. And it's a great way to make a pass on somebody.
The 43 goes around and drops down the charts quickly. That's Mark Valme. Mark had a very poor race yesterday. We're 10, so that turn giving him some issue. He's already been on track today as well, getting some drive car. Ooh, he came through 17 quite sideways again. So that turn giving him some issue. He's already been on track today as well, getting some drive time in the PC car for the 12 hours of Sebring. So he knows what track conditions are like. Now he's got it turned around and pointing in the right direction. Does not come into the Scott Hargrove. He took advantage of Hargrove being slightly distracted through 17 and made the pass up the inside. But we did see a move of Trenton Estep around Scott Hargrove. He took advantage of Hargrove being slightly distracted through 17 and made the pass up the inside. But Hargrove returns the favor, gets a little bit
And even better for that Castrol-livered Pfaff Motorsports entry of Scott Hargrove is that sign has disappeared off the front of that car. So I think by getting tucked up right behind someone else, it took the air pressure away. There's a spin for, was that Cerrone again?
That was the number 45, was it?
Okay, fine. By getting tucked up right behind someone else, it took the air pressure away. There's a spin for, was that Cerrone again?
That was the...
Yeah, so just saw driver coach Randy Pope's back there. You said Randy wasn't here yesterday. Randy, another massively experienced driver, as we watched to see what happened here to Charlie Luck. He's getting on the power coming out of the corner. He's on the outside. Randy wasn't here yesterday. Randy, another massively experienced driver, as we watched to see what happened here to Charlie Luck.
Contingency who's coming down to do this race, shake the rust off, much like Scott Hargrove did. And there is that 45 of Charles Luck the fourth.
So he's got going again. Now a good lead there for Jake Eidson, with Andrew Longe in a very lonely second place relatively at this stage in the race. Trenton Estep, so he's got going again. Now a good lead there for Jake Eidson, with Andrew Longe in a very lonely right behind Corey Ferguson. His teammate, Will Hardiman. Those two actually came together yesterday at one of the restarts, right, looking on the back end of Scott Hargrove is Corey Ferguson. Right behind Corey Ferguson is his teammate, Will Hardiman. Together yesterday under braking for turn seven, but this time the door is sort of half open, but Will Hardiman decides at the discretion, the better part of valor, tucks back into that position. They are dicing for fifth and sixth.
And we saw that damage to Michael Levitas's car was severe enough that he brought it
back into that position. They are dicing for fifth and sixth.
And we saw that damaging a 45-minute sprint race, you don't come to the pit lane unless something is terribly wrong. And for Mike, it is effectively done, because in this form of racing, a 45-minute sprint race, you don't come to the pit lane unless something is terribly wrong. And for Mike Levitas, they're trying to wave him to go back out. They're saying keep going and get points, but Mike clearly feeling that the car is not at an optimum. He's familiar with the cars and is actually running a 2015 model spec.
Yeah, you're right. And
sorry, Jeremy. Corey Fergus just made a dive down the inside of Scott Hargrove and made it stick coming on to model spec.
Yeah, you're right. And
Corey Fergus just made a dive down the inside of Scott Hargrove.
Price Cobb was talking about. Yeah, great move there by Corey Fergus then to move himself up into equal fourth, fifth and sixth, I think, at that stage. Three cars pretty much side by side. Looks like Will Hardiman, though, has got past both of them.
Hardiman saw the opening on the door, saw the two cars in front of him going side by side and said, yeah, that side
drive. All those positions, you know, what, fourth, fifth?
Will Hardiman saw the opening on the door, saw the two cars in front of him going side by side and said, yeah, that side drafting thing, I'll give it a try. Into 17, before he even got to 17, he had made it up into that position, and through 17, he was able to stretch away ever so slightly. But Trenton Estep is the one that we really need to keep an eye on. He is at the head of this battle, and his lap time was just put down the quickest overall throughout the rest of the field. So yeah, he is 1.1 seconds behind Andrew Longe, but he is charging.
Yeah, that was the fastest lap in the race. Scott Hargrove, Sebastian Landy, Jeff Mosing, McKay Snow and Michael DeCassada in car number 31. Battle for fourth on back. Will Hardiman, Corey Ferguson, Scott Hargrove, Sebastian Landy, Jeff Mosing.
One of our top 10 guys, we would have said before the race, yeah, they can win it. So it still is wide open. Trenton Estep in the JDX car. He was picked by Jeremy Dale, and Jeremy has an eye fit, so it still is wide open. Trenton Estep in the JDX car, he would be able to perform. He's not the kind of guy who is satisfied with years like last, no wins. So Trenton has a lot of pressure on him, but the young man hopefully can step up to the plate and deliver for JDX with years like last, no wins. So Trenton has a lot of pressure on him, but the young man hopefully can step up to the plate and deliver for JDX.
Yeah, very impressive is Trenton, a really bright young guy and a really good head on his shoulders. Raced last season, his first season of car racing in F1600 Championship Series here on the West Coast in the U.S. So I think he had a total of 13 wins last season in F1600. He really is a talent, one to watch, and now one of many youngsters making a move into space. So I think he had a total of 13 wins last season in F1600. He really is a talent, one to watch, and now one of many youngsters making a move into sports cars relatively, well, very early in his career, just 17 years of age.
Jake Eidson has checked out a three-second gap on the rest of the field, and he did not like the fact that Trenton Estep had the fastest lap, so he took it back by three. The pace of the car is behind Eidson, about a second off of what he was able to put together. Andrew Long is still in second, Trenton Estep in third, Will Hardiman in fourth, Corey Fergus fifth. Then we find Scott Hargrove leading this pack of brilliance. Hargrove with his hands full of Landy, Mosing, Snow, and De Quesada round out your top 10. Roman De Angelis leads in the gold class. He is 11th overall. And his next closest competition, three cars behind him. So he has a nice bit of a buffer for that gold class lead. But in terms of our leading pack, the number 24, Jake Eidson, he runs for Kelly Moss Road and Race. Second place is Andrew Long, who runs with Wright Motorsport. Third is Trenton Estep with JDX. Fourth is Will Hardiman with More Speed. So our top four cars are four different ways to get there. Four different teams, different setups, different ideas. And clearly, Jeremy, Sebastian Landy,
then, who's actually moved up a
Hargrove
place or two.
Hargrove dropped back.
Yeah.
Hargrove must have had an issue somewhere around that lap, because he has gone from being just ahead of Landy to now being behind De Quesada. That is a big, big change-up in terms of that battle. See if maybe we can get an idea of what happened.
This is a little bit further back in the pack.
Oh, a spinner for C.J. Wilson. That is that C.J. Wilson, by the way. That is the name that you recognize, a former professional athlete in terms of baseball, is now become a professional athlete in terms of racing. So the dealership owner out in California has decided to ply his trade behind the wheel, and first racing weekend for C.J. Back out in California has decided to ply his trade behind the wheel, and first racing weekend for C.J. Back out at the front of the field, Jake Eidson, racing lap so far. 34 minutes elapsed, and we have 34 minutes to go. Excuse the rest of the pack on the fifth racing lap so far. 34 minutes elapsed, and we have 34 minutes to go. Excuse me. And we have Hargrove. Crew guys are examining the front of the car, and the door is open on the driver's side. So this is race done for Scott Hargrove. Winner in the first round of the championship this year. Was not going for a championship here. He is still committed to the Canadian version of this series, as Marco Cerroni, another Canadian, brings his car onto pit lane as well. But Hargrove is out, gives a sad fist bump to the crew member, and we will have another new winner in the 2017 spec of car, Jeremy.
We will, and we'll have a new championship leader as well. Of course, it was Scott Hargrove led the championship after the first round yesterday, which he won the first race of the season. There's a spin there for Phil Bloom. Who was right on the end of that pack of cars, dicing for 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. There's a spin there for Phil Bloom. Who was right on the end of that tape that on the order.
So our top five have not changed then. Jake Eidson, Andrew Longe, Tristan Estep, Will Hardiman, and Corey Fergus. Now Sebastian Landy is up into sixth. He is only 3 seconds behind the 00 of Corey Fergus. Behind Landy is McKay Snow. Then Jeffy is up into sixth. He is only 3 seconds behind the 00 of Corey Fergus. Behind in the Masters class yet. It's still within the platinum category, but it's for drivers of a certain age. If you are automatically born in or before, I'm not going to sell those drivers out because I like them too much, then you are put into that category. So all the youngsterly born in or before, I'm not going to sell those drivers out because I like them too much. Then you right now, Jeff Mosing is leading that class. Second is Sean McCaig from Canada. And in third is David Baker. He has been running in this series for a very long time. So David, familiar with the cars, of course, wanted to come back with the new machinery, though, with that number 56 car that he so often runs. Only three cars are not running at their full optimum at this point in time. Mike Levitas has brought it to the pit lane and called it a day in the number 36. Scott Hargrove, of course, as we just saw, in the number 9. And Marco Cerroni, who came into the pit lane during that day in the number 36. Scott Hargrove, of course, as we just saw, in the number 9. And Marco Cerroni, who is well off the pace. He's almost a lap down. He's not. Has now also left the pit lane, but he is well off the pace.
Maybe look inside turn 12, not quite close enough there, but Andrew Long's car looks really loose to me at turn 10. That's going to give Trenton Estep an opportunity. Maybe look inside turn 12, not quite close enough there. But
that will be. And for Andrew, he is from Naples, Florida, so not too far away. Oh, just overshot his braking point a little bit through the twisty part on the backside of the track, and it gave Tristan Estep, Florida, so not too far away. Oh, just overshot his braking point a little bit through the twisty part around on the back stretch. He lost it completely by himself. Tristan Estep now moves the blood in the water. He knows that there's opportunity, and Andrew Long goes around on the back stretch. He lost it completely by himself. Tristan Estep now moves up into third. Andrew's still struggling to try.
I mean, that was a matter of time, the way that car looked on that lap. Clearly, they've missed the setup a little bit on that right motorsports entry for Andrew. I mean, it was great, obviously, the first couple of laps, but after that, he's been struggling. And now, Trenton Estep stepped up into second place. But tell you what, the guy who's tracking him down now is Will Hardiman, who's going very, very quickly.
And for Trenton Estep, he's...
But tell you what, the guy who's tracking him down now is Will Hardiman, who's going...
Because he's got 5 seconds to Jake Eidson. That's going to take a lot of work, putting his head down and trying to get back up there. The other thing we're going to have to keep an eye on, though, Jeremy, are those other Wright Motorsports cars in the field, because there are a handful. And if Andrew Long was having issue off of a setup that they did on his car, to keep an eye on, though, Jeremy, are those other Wright Motorsports cars in the field, because there are a handful. And if Andrew, because there are still just under 30 minutes remaining in this race. We need to just have that in the back of our mind, because there are still just under 30 minutes remaining.
At turn 7 down the hairpin, and he goes on wide and loses several positions as well, including one to Andrew. Sideways, completely sideways. Ooh. Under braking down at turn 7 down the hairpin, and he goes on wide.
Well, for Jeff Mosing as well, that's a rare mistake. He's sort of the guy who's calm and cool and sits back. He just locked the rears going into turn 7. Lost the car a little bit and was able to get it back. He's sort of the guy who's calm and cool and sits back. He just locked the rears going into turn 7. Lost the car a little bit and was able to get it back at least before too many people had gone through. But it was Luck in the number 45. Luck's car stationary around the track. Now he gets it going again. Missing a large chunk from the nose, though. Just the body paneling. That's going to affect the way his car handles, though. Stationary around the track. Now he gets it going again. Missing a large chunk from the nose, though. Just the body paneling.
Just outside the top 20, because I think Charlie had a bit of an incident a little while ago as well. So it's been an action-packed race for him. And that's another one of the Wright Motorsports entries. So I don't know whether he's struggling a little bit with the handling as well.
He is in the gold class, and he's been racing since 1982 when he started in stock cars. So maybe there was a little bit of nudging going on, but... he's been racing since 1982 when he started in stock cars, so Maybe there was a little...
Then kind of retired from racing. I think he was 26 at the time, and the Xfinity Series, so the second tier of NASCAR. Then kind of retired from racing.
Caused the incident, and we see Ori sitting out there. Okay, so
Ori Fadani.
That's a replay of what caused the incident. And we see Ori sitting out there. Okay, so Charlie spun on his own then in the same Porsche individually. They didn't actually touch each other.
Yeah. So but back to Charlie. Like he was making his way up the sport, and then decided that he needed to concentrate on the family business, and he took over from his father as I think it's third generation of running the
Luckstone.
Yeah, Luckstone. Yep. It's not mining. What do you call it? Mining, basically. Running the
Luckstone.
Yeah, Luckstone. Yep. Not mining. What do you call it? And now he's comfortable with coming back and doing some racing, at least on a part-time basis, and hopefully more than that. So a lot of experience, but quite a few years ago for Charlie Luck. Meanwhile, Jake Edson racing, at least on a part-time basis, and hopefully more than that. So a lot of experience, but quite a few years ago for Charlie Luck. Meanwhile, Jake Edson out of the front there. Last lap around was a 2 minutes fast, but not quite as consistent as he will want to be later on in the season. But hey, he's brand new to it. Also, Will Hardiman must have made a mistake on that last lap as well. He's dropped a couple of seconds more farther behind at Trenton Estep.
Ori Fadani brought his number 13 car back into the pit lane and got
last lap as well. He's dropped a couple of seconds more farther behind at Trenton Estep.
Ori Fadani's Alain Metney running with the Gold Cup category. As he was seven, that is the number 99. That's Alain Metney running with the. Been something a little bit funny there, Jeremy. It was an orange Porsche on the bottom, but Alain, another car. I think there might have been something a little bit funny there, Jeremy. The Sunday Group sticker on the bumper, so not too bad, but it will affect the handling of the car and the to that car. Just a little bit of the bumper broken near the Sunday Group sticker on the bumper, so not out. And Ori is somebody who is a Gold Cup champion in Canada, so for him to have cars that we have retired now with the number 13 out. And Ori is somebody who is a Gold Cup down.
Yeah, that's true. The good news is that Roman De Angelis, the youngster, still leads the Gold Club class in eighth.
Not boding too well for our Canadian contingency who have come down.
Yeah, that's true. The good news is that Roman De Angelis, the youngster, still leads the Gold Club class in eighth position overall. And he's still potentially on for a top five if the kind of cards fall his way.
Andrew Longe and Jeff Mosing still battling, trying to both make their way back up the field, fighting for the ninth position. The number four, Sean McKechnie, is the next of our gold to Jeff Mosing. He's getting there pretty quickly. He's only got about 5 seconds back now. It was quite a bit more than that before the spin, though. Jake Edson leading and quite happily putting in lap times that not topping the charts, not going purple on our screen, as you mentioned, Jeremy, but he's doing a good job of controlling this race and doing exactly what he needs to do to win a championship.
Yeah, absolutely right. And last lap was a little bit quicker than the one before. He did a 2 minutes 5.4 this last lap, a 2 minutes 5.7.
To win a championship.
Yeah, absolutely right. And last lap was a little bit quicker than the one before. He did a 2 minutes 5.4 this last lap, a 2 minutes 5.7 the previous lap, and 2 minutes 6 before that. So he's just, I think, settling into what for him at least is a comfortable pace. And that's allowing him to extend his lead by around about half a second a lap over Trenton Estep in second place. He comes across the line now.
Not shaken off his teammate, though, because the number 19 car from More Speed has that double zero car right behind him of Corey Fergus. They're about 6 tenths of a second apart as they cross the start finish. Number 19 car from More Speed has that double zero car right behind him of Corey Fergus. And is that number 78, so seventh overall for our gold class leader.
Yes, he's just picked up a position on this last lap because number 31, Michael De Quesada, has had another spin, I think, somewhere probably in the third sector because he lost 8 seconds in that third sector. So is that a replay of it?
No, I don't believe that.
Had another spin, I think, somewhere probably in the third sector because he lost 8 seconds in that third sector. So is that a replay of it?
No, I don't believe that is a replay.
Somebody else, huh?
We are seeing somebody else with gold headlights off. That's the number 99 again. So Alain Metteny's troubles continue as he tries to make his way around the lap. Comes behind Charlie Luck, going around the backside of the circuit, locks up the rears. Ooh, sees Charlie Luck spinning in front of him. He goes off into the dirt and, ooh, smacks the tires hard. Incident in front of you. By going off onto the dirt where you've got absolutely no traction, you have to pick a side, left or right. There wasn't really enough time to jerk the car back all the way to the right without causing yourself to spin and then hit the car that was stopped there. Well, the stopped car was Charlie Luck. He's continued around the track as he crosses the start-finish line now. And Metteny is just now starting to get going. Full course caution is out, though. Continued around the track as he crosses the start-finish line now. And Metteny is just now starting to get going.
Rado, who made a exploratory foray into this Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge USA by Jake Edson's lead, the 21-year-old from Littleton, Colorado, who made a exploratory foray into this Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge USA by Yokohama last year at Road America. Just did one the one weekend for Kelly Moss Road and Race. Came away with two very impressive second place finishes behind the eventual series champion, Jesse Lazare. And resolved there and then to try and put together a deal for this year, has done so primarily as a result of winning the inaugural Hurley Hayward Scholarship, which is supported by Ford, by IMSA. Only doing just doing this weekend, not planning on running the whole championship, that put Estep Edson already into the catbird seat.
Ooh, we just got another view of that incident, and it looks like the rear wing no longer says Porsche. It might just say Porsche, because the last bit of it was picked up by a safety worker, and I don't think there is an E wing. No longer says Porsche. It might just say Porsche, because the last bit of it was picked up by a safety worker, and I don't think there is an E on the end of that anymore. It actually split the wing in a not entirely desirable location. Yep, the wing actually cuts off P-O-R-S-C-H. So it is now abbreviated in terms of a car name, but Alain Metteny managing to continue around the lap, going very slowly, smart driving by him. So Jake Edson will not be happy to see on 17, and then calling it quits. So Jake, but the good news, he wasn't really pushing his Yokohama tires before that came out. The cars behind him, well, they were most certainly pushing their Yokohamas. Trenton Estep was trying very hard to close the gap to the first position. And Will Hardiman had his hands full of his teammate, Corey Fergus, and Sebastian Landy behind him. McKay Snow is in the sixth position. And Will Hardiman had his hands full of his teammate, Corey Fergus, and Sebastian Landy behind E9 making its way onto the pit lane. Our Gold Cup leader, seventh overall. You talked to him before the race today, and he said he would like a top five. That's looking like it is possible at this point.
Well, it certainly is, considering the number of incidents we've had so far. Another very, very impressive ride.
That's looking like it is possible at this point.
Well, it certainly is, considering the number of incidents we've had so far. But he got the call from Mark Motors Racing, and here he is. And loving every minute. There's Michael DeCasado's just made his way onto pit lane as well. He's been up and down all over the place. He was up as high as he is. And loving every minute. There's Michael DeCasado's just made his way onto pit lane as well. He resumed at the back of the pack.
Lights are out on the beautiful blue Porsche safety car. As Jake Edson not doing anything to clean his tires off at all, so must be feeling pretty good about going back to the restart. Now he's got Trenton Estep behind him, who he doesn't really know how he races. Ooh, and Will Hardiman has a damaged left rear wing. Gosh, I wonder how that happened.
Yeah,
that's an odd angle.
I didn't notice it earlier. It seems to have got a crease in it. It's kind of folded down, isn't it, on the left hand outside of the wing stay, the wing support. I didn't notice this earlier. It seems to have got a crease in it. It's kind of folded down, isn't it, on the left-hand outside of place, and the wing sort of hangs out proud from that, but it's folded down. So that's not going to improve the handling characteristics of that car number 19.
Well, and the sort of funny thing is, Jeremy, that his teammate is right behind him, so you know that Corey Fergus is going to be on the wall to all of the more speed guys going, guys, Hardiman needs to come in. He can't keep racing it. His wing is broken. Nope, I need that third position. Oh, did I say that out loud? as they come through 17. The safety car has peeled off, and Eidson with a good jump on the rest of the field as the green flag waves, and we get back to racing with 18 minutes to go. Jake Eidson and Eidson with a good jump on the rest of the field as the green flag waves, and we get back to racing is in third, Corey Fergus fourth, Sebastian Landy and McKay Snow fifth and sixth, and Andrew Longe passed our Gold Cup leader on that restart, so now he is back up into seventh position. Remember, he had been running as high as second earlier on in the race. Charlie Luck comes onto the pit lane as well, and then that restart, so now he is back up into seventh position. Remember, he had been running as high as second earlier on in the race. Charlie Luck comes onto the pit lane as well in the number 45, but Jake Eidson, the man who will be most happy that that thing got back going cleanly, because he had that lead when we went to yellow. Well, he has it now that we're back to green as well, and Will Hardiman having to fight hard against Corey Fergus to keep that.
Yeah, we've got 17 minutes remaining in this race then, so
functioning the way that it's supposed to, and Corey Fergus knows it.
Yeah, for things to change, and Trenton Estep staying right with Jake Eidson as they're halfway around this restart lap. That Hertz gold, black and gold machine from JDX Racing running in the second place. Trenton Estep is his very first weekend in these cars. It's Jake Eidson who's out front for Kelly Moss Roden Race in the Hurley Hayward Scholarship car. It's just his second weekend in a Porsche
exactly.
as well. So the ironic thing about all this, perhaps, is that Will Hardiman, who's running in third place, he's got a lot more experience in these cars than these other guys, but very little experience overall. He only started racing a couple of years ago, absolutely knew nothing about the sport even the year before that. He just happened, he lives in Austin, Texas, got invited to a track day out at Circuit of the Americas, and it just happened that David Moore and the Moore Speed team was there running some cars, and he got behind the wheel and he impressed them right away with his attitude, with his speed, and with his just the way he approached the day. And they said, hey, have you thought about making a career out of this? He said, no. Well, maybe you should. And here he is 2 years later, after making his debut here at Sebring in 2015, running up at the front towards the front of the field. He said, no. Well, maybe you should. And here he is. 2 years later, after making his debut here at Sebring.
Not pull into the pit lane and call it a day. Last year, he was fifth and eighth here at Sebring International Raceway. So to be sitting in that third position is already a massive improvement for himself. He was fifth in the championship in 2016 after missing four races. Position is already a massive improvement for himself. He was fifth in the championship in 26, championship contender in that number 19 car. He is somebody that we will be watching all year with lots of interest.
Absolutely right, and considering the steep learning curve that he's faced with, you know, no prior racing experience at all prior to the first race here in 2015, improved really rapidly. He had his best finish at Road Atlanta the final weekend of last season in the first of two races. He's just getting better and better and better, as of course you do with experience, because that is one of the keys in this sport, just learning, knowing what it takes. Right behind that as well.
He is trying as well to hold on to the cars in front of him, because Trenton Estep pulling out a little bit of a gap, just over a second and a half, almost 2 seconds, since there's well to hold on to the cars in front of him, because Trenton Estep pulling out a little bit of a gap, just over a problem from the number 24. The two of them separated by half a second as they come into turn 17, and Hardiman just dropping off ever so slightly, now 2 seconds back from that battle by half a second as they come into turn 17. And Hardiman just dropping off past his teammate. But he knows, especially after yesterday, rule number one, do not take out your teammate.
Yeah, that's right. And certainly, I think that'll be a bit of a handful for Will Hardiman in the third place, particularly in the high-speed corners. But he's doing a fantastic job of not showing that and maintaining very, very good pace in that third position.
He is, and Jake Eidson is doing an excellent job of not crumbling under pressure, because Trenton Estep has been all over him. He's been showing him in every corner, I'm in your mirrors, I'm right behind you, I want to pass you. Hasn't been letting that affect him at all. Now, whether Jake Eidson has decided that his mirrors no longer, every corner, I'm in your mirrors, I'm right behind you, I want to pass you, hasn't been letting that affect, not saying that you block, but saying that you focus on your own race. whether he's doing that or whether it's just not important to do when you are leading at certain points in the race, not saying that you block, but saying that you focus on your own race, whether he's doing that or whether it's just not affecting him at all. As we have our second place in Masters class has gone off. That's Sean McKeag, one of our Canadian drivers coming down for this race, which means that David Baker has gone into the second position for the Masters class. Sean got going again in that number 34 car. He's now down to 13th, 14th overall. And he might have gotten a bit of help from Anthony Imparato there in the number 91 cars. It looked like Sean spin not completely of his own doing there. Important to mention also that Jeff Mosing continues to lead in the Masters class. So David Baker, second.
We had breakfast this morning, didn't we? He went into turn 16 in the early stages of the race, saw a couple of cars spinning ahead of him, thought, oh, great, I can pick up three positions here. And then the next minute he knows he's spinning as well. There's some fluid on the track, and it caught him out as well as the guys ahead of him, and he was really kicking himself. He's been around this sport long enough to have really realized perhaps the reason those three, there is a reason for those three cars spinning, particularly as they weren't far ahead of him on the racetrack. But around he went, and he spent a bit of time fishing around for the right gear to resume. So there is a reason for those three cars spinning, particularly as they weren't far ahead of him on the racetrack. But around he went and finished ultimately in the 10th position, and as you say, won that Masters class. Really good job to work his way back up the order as well, and finish ultimately in the 10th position.
It's him, though. So now he's back up to 8th overall, still leading the Gold Cup class as he can hold on again. Roman De Angelis just passed him, though. So now he's back up to 8th overall, still leading the Gold Cup class as Jeff Mosing now has a couple of cars between. Oh, no, Roman's now dropped back down. Must have been a timing glitch there as the cars continue to circulate around. And there is Jeff Mosing, and behind him is Phil Bloom. And there, again, he is the one being chased, not the chaser. And that always makes you push a little bit harder. Jeff Mosing currently with the advantage. But again, he is the one being chased, not the chase. On that other car, use that as inspiration to try and move up the grid a bit. But it's never fun when ahead of him, so he can focus ahead on that other car, use that as inspiration to try and...
Certainly, and the battle's all the way up and down the field. Here's a look at CJ Wilson coming down in two turns.
You really want your position.
Yeah, you're right there, certainly, and the battle's all the way up and down the field. He's made a couple of places since the restart, other people being very obliging. 18th position, made up... He's made a couple of places since the race. He was involved in an incident earlier in the race. So CJ Wilson on his professional debut as a racing driver here. In his mirrors there is Mark Kouame, who was involved in an incident earlier in the race. So CJ, he's currently 14th in the Platinum class. That's worth a couple of championship points.
Well, and like we were saying, that when you can see a car ahead of you, it makes you push a little bit more. That is the situation for the number 33 right now. He has a train of three cars in front of him, and they're all Gold Cup cars. So CJ should be able to catch up to them and get by them. That is the situation for the number 33 right now. He has a train of three cars in front of him, and they're all Gold Cup cars. So CJ should be able to catch up to them and get by them. A little bit further down in the field, Sean McKeag has now gotten going again. He is now back battling with the number 42 of Bill Smith. And the two of them are fighting, even though they are in two different specifications of car. Bill Smith is in the Gold Cup class, which means that his car is slightly older. His is a 2014 model year. And McKeag's car is a brand new 2017 model year. So the 17, as we've been talking about, more power. It's a different car. It passes the Gold Cup car with quite a bit of ease in between turn 16 and 17. And Trenton Estep now has just under eight tenths of a second to catch up to Jake Eidson. But the good news for that youngster is behind him. He's got Fergus and Fergus Landy and Snow right behind him as well. So make a small mistake, Will Hardiman goes from third. Fergus Landy and Snow right behind him as well. So make a small mistake, Will Hardiman goes from third down to seventh.
Yeah, he does. But he's managed to, through the S's there. There's really only two or three car lengths between them. So very much under pressure remains Will Hardiman in that third position. He'll be thrilled with that result if he can stay there. He started in eighth in this race on the grid. So he's done very, very well to move himself up into third place, particularly with that ripped result, if he can stay there. He started in eighth in this race on the grid, so he's done very, very well to move himself up.
I can put a bungee cord between those four cars.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
It really feels like they just have this. I mean, when you disappeared a little earlier, did you go into the Porsche paddock and put a bungee cord between those four cars?
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
It really feels like they just have this desire to all group together. Again, that's another rear wing of Will Hardeman's where it says Porsche.
Yeah, and
the
I think the decal there is actually holding it all together, it looks like to me.
However, the engineering, you need to make your car go quickly, then we approve. Corey Fergus, though, will be sitting back in that fourth position, just chomping at the bit for an opportunity to get around his teammate. Jake Eidson and Trenton Estep closer that time by, half a second now between the top two cars. Great story, that young man is super impressive. He is a student at Babson, and you get into Babson by McKay Snow. And Sebastian Landy, what a great story, that young man is super impressive. He is a student at Babson, and you get into Babson by being the tip top, the cream of the crop. It is a business university up in Boston. He's dedicated to his studies because he realizes that being a race car driver might not work out. Being a businessman gives you a lot better chance at having some success in the world. And so he is doing school and then racing. But last year, competed in the Gold Cup class, ultimately Michael De Quesada who won that. But right now, Michael is back in 24th, and Sebastian Landy races than some of his other competitors. So it was also ultimately Michael De Quesada who won that. But right now,
He won most races, and that's good. But I think you're going to a business school. It's a good idea. I mean, it's going to give you good understanding.
Ultimately get that championship right now.
No, and I think you won most races, and that's good. But I think you're going to a business school. It's a good idea. I mean, it's going to give you a good understanding of the business world and what makes the motor racing world round go around as
Marco Cerroni goes around.
Needs to go around is business basic by that young man.
Marco Cerroni in the number 88 decided to
duck. Good career choice there by that young man.
Marco Cerroni in the number 88 decided to dive down the inside of the numbers 80 and 22, both going into turn 7. 22 got a bit of lock up there, and Cerroni spun around all on his own. Didn't hit anything, though. That's the good news. Waited for the rest of the cars to come through before he rejoins. So now he'll be back in. That will be hard to swallow.
That battle continues at the front, though. Good consistent laps by Jake Eidson, but Trenton Estep staying absolutely right with him. They're pulling away now from Will Hardeman in the third place.
Ooh, but Eidson dropped a wheel coming out of turn one and got very sideways. It let Eidson just get that little bit closer. I think Eidson might have actually lifted off the throttle seeing the cloud of dust because he didn't want to accidentally hit anybody in that dust. Very heads-up move by the number three. Jake Eidson, though, not at all rattled by dropping a wheel. He's flashing the headlights, seeing slower cars up ahead, coming in to lap some of the competitors as whoever that was just went four wheels off. Headlights, seeing slower cars up ahead, coming in to lap some of the competitors as whoever that was just went four wheels off coming out of turn seven, deciding that the Yokohama tires are very good off-roading, and that's Alain Metney again in the number 99. He's been having a rough race, but at least he did move off the racing line and let the leaders through completely. Trenton Estep dropped back quite a bit, though, from Jake Eidson through turn seven onwards, now coming into a higher speed portion. Six and 34 are all together. Again, magnet, spongy cord, what you do, Jeremy?
Yeah, it is. It's close, isn't it? Really good battle going on there. And
magnet, spongy cord, what you do, Jeremy?
Yeah, it is. It's close, isn't it? Really good battle going on there. And there's a spin.
And Mark Vame and Sean McKeag spin in tandem in turn seven.
I don't think it was in. And lost it under braking. That's curious. Might be some fluids down there on the racetrack, perhaps. And lost it under braking. That's curious. Might be some fluids down there on the racetrack, perhaps. What I was going to say was that Andrew Longe, who was running second place in the early stages Then had, I think he had a spin, didn't he? Dropped himself back, and he's now falling well back from that battle for third, fourth, fifth, and sixth position, and kind of back into the clutches now, almost, of Jeff Mosing in the double.
Keg, I think there was just a little bit of a tap as they came into that breaking point, but it would have just been ever so slight. Jake Eidson, 19 laps complete, is our leader with 3 minutes left on the clock. That means we should get about two more laps. But he has stretched out a 1.3-second gap over Trenton Estep in second position. Will Hardiman still in third. He's still holding on to that position, Jeremy. And his teammate, Corey Fergus, almost a second back now in fourth. Sebastian Landy, fifth. McKay Snow, sixth. Andrew Longe, seventh, as you just said. Sebastian Landy, fifth. McKay Snow, sixth. Andrew Longe, seventh, as you just said. And then the first of our Masters class in eighth, that is Jeff Mosing. Roman De Angelis continues this stage of the race, but he is still leading the Gold Cup class as a whole. 26 cars left out on track as well, with 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining. They're enough about.
So time ticking away here. Probably won't be the white flag next time around. I would suggest, the white flag has been readied on the starter stand in front of us. And Jake Eidson driving really nicely here. Trenton Estep, boy, he put him under a lot of pressure. Slipped back just a little bit on that last lap, but still close enough, certainly, to be able to take advantage should there be any slip at all from Jake Eidson in car number 24.
And really good tire management from Eidson as well, because he had that moment early on in the race where he had a large gap eviscerated by a yellow flag. Didn't panic, kept his tires underneath him and used them exactly as he needed to. So to now have a comfortable gap as this race is winding down is smart driving. As we have another pit lane caller, the number 22 has come smart driving. Come into the pit lane. That was one of the ones that was a spinner, but the Whiting did not get a win last year. They did make it to the podium.
Will Hardiman's dropped back there because all of a sudden he's lost three positions on that lap in car number 19.
His wing has collapsed.
Yep.
The left-hand strut of the wing has completely gone, and that will now be...
Yep.
The left-hand strut of the wing has completely gone, and that will now be not only negatively affecting him, but it will be handling the car in a weird position. I would be surprised if he can get that Porsche back around one more time without slowing down even more. Yep. Bad news for Will Hardiman, who was looking so strong here in the early running of this race. Corey Fergus, though, the beneficiary of all this, and it is still a more speed podium if Fergus can hold on from Landy. But Sebastian Landy is only 0.3 behind Corey Fergus, and he will be sniffing his first ever overall podium. It's that man, though. It is Jake Eidson, who is counting down every second. Time has now elapsed. We are being told last lap official. We saw the white flag. The wing on, Hardiman goes around. The wing comes off on the backside of the track. Ooh. And Hardiman has a violent spin. Just barely worker to let him know when it is safe to go. Thank you, corner workers all over the track, for being out there and helping. Hardiman, very, very smart to wait for a safety worker to let him know when it is safe to go. Thank you.
It's really unfortunate for Will. It's a great drive there, and one presumes the air pressure finally won.
No rear wing, though. Back it down, son.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate for Will. It's a great drive there, and one on two of the 2017 Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge USA by Yokohama.
The white flag in the air, now it's being swapped out for that black and white checkered flag, and Jake Eidson will be the first one to see it. He has done four IMSA GT3 Cup races. That black and white checkered flag, and Jake Eidson will be the first one to see it. He has done four before he gets that first ever win. Trenton Estep comes home in the second position for that second place finishes. Yesterday got another second place, not long before he gets that first ever win. Trenton Estep comes home in the second position for that number three JDX Racing, and Corey Fergus with a very solid top five finish for Wright Motorsports in that number 63, and the number 49 comes home fourth, and McKay Snow with a very solid top five finish for Wright Motorsports in that number 63 car. That is our top five. Jeff Seth Mosing is our Gold Cup, our Masters class winner, and our Gold Cup winner is Roman De Angelis. Two races this weekend, two wins. What an impressive debut.
So Lisa gets some points out of the day.
Still, when you have that glimpse of a first
overall, that'll be 11th in platinum. So Lisa gets some points out of the day.
To see that and then see it go away in such a spectacular fashion, that's going to sting Will Hardiman for when you finished 5th and 8th last year. To see that and then see it go away in such a spectacular, coming in April, only 4 weeks away, so Will Hardiman won't have to stew on what could have been for too long. But Jake Eidson will be partying. He will be a happy camper. So Will Hardiman won't have to stew on what could have been for too long. But Jake Eidson will start, but the points lead. And this is somebody who has entered this championship declaring that he wants to be the 2017 IMSA Porsche GT3 Cup Challenge by Yokohama champion. Entered this championship declaring that he wants to be the 2017 IMSA Porsche GT3.
Yeah, he certainly impressed everybody at Porsche and Kelly Moss Road and Race last year when he finished second in those two races at Road America. He was a former champion in the Skip Barber Racing Series. He won the FC Road and Race last year when he finished second in those two races at Road America. He was a former champ then. He's been on the Mazda Road to Indy, finishing regularly among the top winning races in USF 2000, and had some strong results in Pro Mazda last year before realizing he didn't have a shot at the champ. Regularly among the top winning races in USF 2000, and had some strong results in Pro Mazda last year, and now he's looking to take full advantage of that. And I know Hurley Haywood, who is here today, I haven't seen him personally, but I know he's here. I know Hurley will be very proud because Hurley was very impressed with Jake when he was part of that group that was being assessed for the inaugural Hurley Haywood Scholarship. And Jake has done him proud. He had a second place finish yesterday, and this victory, a fine victory today for Kelly Moss Road and Race.
And it's one thing when your team greets you. It's another thing when Porsche or people are there to celebrate with you. Thank you so much for being with us for this second round of the 2017 championship. We'll be back for more to celebrate with you. Thank you so much for being with us for this second round of the 2017 championship.